My name is Carmel Majidi. I'm an assistant professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering. I joined the faculty 3 years ago, back in fall 2011. And I direct a research group called the Soft Machines Lab. The Soft Machines Lab is a group dedicated to engineering new classes of multifunctional materials that could potentially be used in next generation wearable devices, machines, and robots that would be compatible with human tissue. Most recently, I and my research lab have been looking at the field of what are called soft robots. These would be robots and machines that are made almost entirely out of soft, non-rigid materials. Think about, instead of engineering a robot out of hard plastics, out of rigid metals, brittle semiconductors, we would build them out of elastomers, rubber, soft polymers, potentially even gels or fluids. The idea here is that increasingly a lot of these technologies in robotics, what are known as co-robots or robots that cooperate with humans, as well as with personal electronics, wearable computing, these are all going to be technologies that interact intimately with the body. And so in order for that interaction to be safe, those technologies have to match a lot of the same elastic and rheological properties of natural human tissue. These new classes of materials and technologies, it would be safe, but it'll also preserve our ability to just freely move. And it would be lightweight. You don't have to kind of deal with all the kind of additional burden of having all this kind of hardware strapped to your body. You can think about a lot of these soft matter technologies almost as functioning as artificial skin, artificial nervous tissue, artificial muscle that can help support or augment the corresponding natural tissues that we have in our body. This effort to re-engineer machines, circuits, sensors out of soft materials is very ambitious. And it's going to take a very comprehensive effort, not just in terms of manufacturing techniques, but also design principles, theoretical modeling tools. And it's going to, in large part, build on fundamental practices in engineering. There's a lot of open questions and a lot of very intellectually stimulating questions related to how does the mechanics, the elastic deformation of these materials interface with their electronic functionality, type of support or assistance they can provide to the human body, the impact on natural bodily function. There's kind of a lot of open questions there that we can examine using rational tools and practices in engineering. But before we get to that point, we really have to have mature technologies that we can be confident in, that we can produce reliably in a repeatable fashion. And really that kind of is the stage that we're at right now with the Soft Machines Lab. There's a huge set of fundamental problems that can be addressed once when we have these technologies in place.